Okay, so we're ready to go for the final leg of this flight to Barbados. I've evened out the fuel capacity a little bit. And I figure what we're going to do on this takeoff run here is we're going to simulate an engine failure at V1 at 100 knots or so. And then we're going to see if we can still take off on three engines, like we should be able to, with the flaps at 15 degrees. And we'll leave the number one engine windmilling. And we should be able to climb, you know, 300 feet a minute, approximately. So that'll be a good test. So we gotta go about 1,200 miles to the south. I didn't top up the fuel tanks because we have plenty of fuel. What happens? Engine failure on takeoff in 3, 2, 1. Boom. Okay. Airplane swings a bit. We need a bunch of right rudder. No problem. Can we make V2? We have V2, so we should be able to climb now. We're off the ground. Feet a minute or so. Keep the ball centered. Oh yeah, no problem. A little bit of turbulence there. Huh. Not a major emergency. Performance seems realistic. Alright, so let's get the... What would we do in real life here? We would get the landing gear up. We would get that propeller feathered. Did it feather? I don't know. Looks like it did. Nice. Okay. We're hitting an updraft here. Thermals, which is good. That helps us a bit. I'll start getting the flaps up now. We gotta accelerate to a climb speed. Get the flaps up. Turn to the south. Success. Alright, let's see if we can restart that engine. Turn the fuel back on. We'll hit the starter for number one. Did it start? Looks like it did. Now we got 3,000 RPM on it. Unfeather it. As we climb away from Bermuda here. Not a very big place, is it? I've never been there myself. Definitely not a big place. The sun's starting to go down here. So this particular airplane was one of 20 of this model that were built for TransCanada Airlines. It entered service in March of 1948, and it served until July of 1961. And it was scrapped somewhere over in the UK. In 1964 or 65, I think. It's time to turn on some cockpit lights here. So let's, what are we doing here? Let's check out the main panel. Nice, we got some red lighting. This looks pretty soft light. It's pretty good, I like that. Navigator's table's lit up. Currently, about halfway there. Some Caribbean islands coming up here on the right-hand side. St. Martin and all those places that I've never been to. So it appears that the cabin lighting is already turned on. Even though I haven't actually turned the cabin lights on yet. That would be this switch here. And that made no difference. Now one of the bugs was that the navigation lights don't work. They actually turn on the rotating beacon. Which is also turned on by the beacon switch. So that bug's been fixed already. I don't have the update yet, but in communication with the people there at Flight Replicas, they've assured me that that bug has been corrected. Let me see here. Turn the nav lights on. I don't have the wing lights. Wing illumination. So if that works. No, that doesn't seem to do anything either. Maybe that's part of the same bug. I've never tried it until now, so. See some islands passing us on the right-hand side there. Alright. This is going to be a night landing. We are 200 miles away. You can see all the islands there on the right-hand side. Our ground speed's 217, so we're about one hour away. Grantley Adams. I'm not too sure who that was, but the airport's named after him. Visibility is supposed to be greater than 20 miles. Looks like we just ran into a layer of fog here. Maybe let's get an update. Well, we went from clear to thunderstorms in the area. That's what happens when real world weather decides to update all of a sudden. Oh well, I should have used the ILS. Oh well. Sorry passengers, you're gonna have to deal with light rain. Temperature is nice though, 23. Not too bad. This thing doesn't want to come down. Flaps are full. There we go. She's coming down now. All right. Nice. I like the thunderstorms. Makes for a more exciting video. Small bounce there. We are on the ground. Okay, let's get the flaps up to 15. So there we go. We made it. Too bad it's raining, but next up, I think I'll look at the Captain Sim 727.